Hi, and welcome to this episode number 19 of Discovering Dataflix with me, Johan Brodfeldt. Today, we're going to look at connection to database. We have so far been using the data dictionaries to access the database, and even though they are very, very good and have a complete set of actions for getting data from the database, there might be some occasions where you want to load data from a database table where you do not have a dictionary at the moment. And today we're going to look at how to do that. Normally, when you access a database, you used to do that with SQL. But Dataflix, even though they have a SQL query, from the beginning, they have used a set of commandos called clear, move, and find. And we're going to look at those commandos in this video. But before I start with that, I just want to show you a neat little trick. Because when you start your application, let's run this. Now, normally I go into the menu and select the view I want to show you. But in this case, you can see that the DB test was already there when the application started. See, it already opened. So I don't have to click in the menu. And I thought that was neat. I would save some time in the video. But I also want to show how I did that. So in this case, I go into the this one, main project of my application. I press F7 so I see the code. And then I find, because here I have the menu. So I try to find where is the call that is actually calling my function I want to use. Or I could activate oDBTest. That's the one. So then I go down here and I send activate oDBTest of client area main before the start UI. And this commando is this command is the one that is actually showing the view. But back to the database. First of all, I want to show you a small presentation. Let's see where I have that here. In Dataflix, you have the table. This is the table. You have a data dictionary. No, you have the record buffer. And you have a index. In this case, I have set up an index with the year and the ID. And this is because if I only have the year, then the database would want this to be unique. So you couldn't have two persons with the same year. And we want to have that, of course. And when we come into our code, the record buffer might be filled out with something. We might have done something prior to this part of the code, so we might have some data in the record buffer. That's why we start by clearing the user. So now we have a clean record buffer. Now we want to seed the record buffer with a value. In this case, 1959, because we want to search for everyone who is older than or equally old as 1959. And then we go into the database, and since our primary index value is not set, we will end up here. And year is 1959, so you will check here, and this is not 1959, so it will just go down until it finds 1959. And this find command will do just that. So you will find this one. Now we go down and we print out the username or whatever we want to do. And since this is found, because this find command is setting this found variable, so the one is true, it will loop, go back to the repeat, and look, do we have something greater than 1959? And if we didn't have the ID in the index here, it will go right down to 1961. But since we have the ID, it will also look at the ID column and see that 3 is greater than 2. So it will start by looking at that. So we loop, and now we end up here. And the record buffer is updated with 3, carb, and 1959. And now this Dorothy is, of course, greater. And we continue this until the end. And then we do not find the record number, and we stop and run out of the loop, because found is not indicated as found anymore. But we still have the values in the record buffer, so you will still have the last found user in the record buffer. So let's continue. Now I've started with a application here, and I've added some buttons because I want to show you some samples. And the first button is this one, find equal. And when I click on this, it will clear the user. Maybe I should show you the table I'm using as well. I've set up a user table where I have a set of users with a set of birthdays, and some IDs here. And if we go into the indexes, we can see we have index 1, which is the ID column, because that should be unique. I have index 2, which is name, then surname and ID. So if I have two users with the same name, it will sort by surname. And I could have two users with both the same surname and name, because I have the ID. Same goes for index 3, but that's the opposite. I have surname and name and ID. And then I have birthday and ID, because I want to be able to search on that. This is what we're going to do now. So I seed by moving 10 to user ID, find equal, and if I find something, then I will print it. So I will search by ID to start with. So let's run this one. I click find equal, and this finds the index 10. That's Rosanna Arquette. Now, next one is find equal or not. Now we move 20 into the user ID, and I only have 15 users in my database, so it should not find anything. So then it should show this not found. So we run it again, find equals not found, and it says not found. Because because it's out of range. Find equals by birthday. Now we're gonna seed with 1959 here and see what we find. Birth. Not found. Wait a second. Yeah. We didn't find anyone with 1959. So what happens if we also include 10 here, because I know there is a user with 10 and 1959 on an index 4, need both look at ID and birthday. So let's run this. Now we found Rosanna again. And why is that? Well, that's because we want to find equal, and if we don't set the ID, then we do not have an equal. So we can do this and look at greater than, and now we should find something greater than 1959 and ID 0. So let's try that. And now we find number 9 in 1959 Ving Rhames. And that's just fine because that's the first one according to our index. Now we got some data. This is basically the same. So we skip that one. Now we want to find several with this birthday. So we make a loop, repeat, we found loop. So we run this again and see what happens. Find multi. And now we find everything that is greater than 1959, we get all the way down to the end of the database table. And that may be not what we wanted. Perhaps we only wanted the ones with the birthday 1959. So here's another sample where we do this with name instead. We start by B. And we find greater equal, because we also want to find B in this case. And we go on and check if it's less than C. And if it is less than C, then we indicate found again. And we show that value. Then we look at greater than, because if we have greater or equal here, then we will just stay at the same record all the time, and it will just show the same record, and we will have an infinite loop. So we need to find something that is greater than the one we are standing in. So let's try this one. Yes, there we go. We get everyone starting with a B. Nothing else. And we could actually take this birthday. If we only want 1959, we could take this greater equal. We could say if found, then we look for the next one, and if found user dot birth year. User dot birth year less than 1960 to found. And now this one should only show the ones that are born in 1959. So let's run this. And it does 9, 10, 11, 3, and the same birthday, birth year, I should say. Yes, that's it for this video, and we will continue next time and go more in depth with clear move find and what you can do with multiple tables, and also how you can update tables. As all for now, bye.